Hi, welcome to this video series on creating Bluetooth low energy or wireless LAN tests with Keysight X8711A using C#. In this episode, I will create a C# console project and demonstrate the step-by-step procedure to establish an instrument connection using 34998 driver. This is the mandatory step before we can perform any VLE or wireless LAN tests. Let's start the C# console project in Visual Studio and add 34998 driver DLL as reference to the project. The 34998 DLL is a .NET library assembly that supports both 32-bit and 64-bit program compilation. To add a DLL reference, right-click the Reference tab and select Add Reference. In the pop-up window, go to the Browse tab and click the Browse button. Then, look for the keysight.34998.dll file. By default, the DLL is in the folder as shown on the screen. Select the DLL and click Add. Then press OK. By now, the DLL reference adding is completed. What we need to do next is to import the driver namespaces that are used for instrument session creation. We will import the VLE and wireless LAN namespace as well, which we will be using to perform measurement in the next video. Now, let's move to instrument session creation. First, create an instance of KT34998 class named driver. Set the COM port property to the COM port number of the 34998A. The COM port number can be found in Device Manager under the Port node. In this example, it will be COM5. To establish instrument connection, call driver connect method and pass in the arguments required. The argument resource name of the 34972A can be found in Keysight Connection Expert. To confirm the connection, simply output a console message by checking the identity information of the instrument. Use driver disconnect method to disconnect the instrument from the PC. I'm adding in a 10-second delay to hold the console window from closing before the program's end. Alright, let's run the program and observe the outcome. As you can see, the instrument identity information is shown in the console window. This indicates that the connection to the instrument is successfully established. Well, I hope this is helpful, and in the next episode, we will go through the procedure for performing VLE or wireless LAN measurements. Thank you for watching and for choosing Keysight.